down a little. If you're not ambidextrous, taking up sculpting and doing what I'm doing eventually, you'll get there. It's good practice. I've been doing it for, since the late 70s. So I got plenty of practice. This particular sculpt is about a third in scale. Working in 1/3 scale, it's probably my best scale. It's not too big, it's not too small. It allows me to put a great amount of detail into the piece. A couple of months ago, I finished two pieces for a client in Sweden, and those pieces were probably 10 centimeters. I'm not even sure what scale that would be, 1/6 scale. Anyhow, that was a Rottweiler and a Golden Retriever. Never gonna have those pieces for sale. In the near future, they're getting them manufactured in a foundry in India. They'll be cast in brass. In fact, let's see. The Rottweiler's depicted on that header on this page you're looking at. It's the bottom right thumbnail adjacent to the painting of the lion in Ridgebacks. Kind of shows the head of the Rottweiler. And I didn't know, but in Sweden apparently it's, I don't want to say it's taboo, but it's forbidden to crop the tails on Rottweilers. So the rat was sculpted with the tail. Seems like everything here in the States we like to crop or something. Years ago, they used to also crop the years on the Bulldogs, English Bulldogs. Not for show, but people, they used to just buy them. And that's what you see on TV sometimes, cartoons with cropped up, pointed years on the Bulldogs, and that is a big no-no. So I can understand why certain countries will prohibit people from doing that. If I'm talking too much, just email me, or not email me, I'll just put something and say, be quiet, you're talking too much, and I'll zip it. Legs are being supported with a rod, aluminum rod. I believe it's about 3/8 in diameter of the rod, and it comes from the bottom of the leg all the way up to the torso, ends about here. And the reason I went so thin with the rod is it would allow me to actually make the actual legs thinner, closer to what they actually should be. Sometimes you see sculptures out there where the legs on the subject are too thick, and they make them too thick sometimes for more support, but then breeders would come to you and say, oh, that's a nice piece, but the legs are too thick. The areas that were somewhat rough in texture from the application of the solvent, I'm just rubbing them down right now and making them somewhat smooth right now. It's a good idea to knock it off just before the clay or the solvent on the actual clay evaporates completely. Otherwise, it gets really hard and difficult to work with, and you have to start from scratch all over.